He stepped inside his home, he was overwhelmed with fear. An angel came with words from God, things were still unclear. Saying, read, read, but he could not read. Amazing words that he heard. A trembling deep inside his heart, confused by what had occurred. There was only one who could comfort him, to help him see the light. To ease his fears, to reassure, was Khadija, his wife. He said, Zamiluni, Zamiluni, Dathiruni, Dathiruni.
Inna alhamdulillahi na'maduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nasta'hdihi wa nasta'firuh. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We are back again to talk today in this episode and to continue our program, The Road to Medina. And while talking about the most beloved one to our hearts, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I want everyone sitting there to say sallallahu alaihi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In our episode tonight, inshallah, we will talk about the very important incident that happened to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that we started last episode briefly talking about al-wahy, when the revelation came to our Prophet Huzur sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May peace and blessings be upon him. So I want you to remember with me these days when our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to go away and stay by himself a few days on the mountain of An-Nur, inside the cave of Hira. And he used to reflect and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, supplicate while leaving other disbelievers by themselves, worshipping the idols and doing bad stuff there in Mecca. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was so, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed him and placed him to be the Prophet of Islam. And he was a reason that Allah has taken us away from the darkness to the light, from the darkness of ignorance, darkness of kufr and shirk, to the dark, to the lightness and to the light of this great religion of Islam, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, we are blessed and honored, and we will know more and more about what happens with our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In this hadith of Hadith Aisha, the mother of the believers, when she was talking about the revelation when it came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Jibril, the angel Jibril alayhi salam, he came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the cave of Hira, and he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, commanded him to say to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Iqra." Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would say, "I can't read." After the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah revealed to him, and he heard like a strange voice, somebody's talking to him, "Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq, khalaqa al-insana min 'alaq, iqra wa rabbuka al-akram alladhi 'allama bil qalam 'allama al-insana ma lam ya'lam." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed for him these verses, and he sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so scared, and was so, he lots of fear happens to him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was so like, imagine when you are in such very far place and on the mountain, nobody can see you, and you suddenly hear somebody's talking to you and telling you to read or recite, and you can't read. And we know that his sallam was illiterate. He cannot read and write, alayhi salatu wasalam. So he came so running to his house, to the house of Khadija, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, and she was so shaken, and his heart is full with fear, and he was so scared, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when he arrived to his house, the house of Khadija bint Khuwaylid, the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, "Zammiluni, zammiluni, cover me, cover me." And he was so so cold and so scared and running to his house. So she put the cover on him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she started to calm him down. And while he's saying to her, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "I was very scared on myself that something wrong will happen to me." So imagine and look at the answer of Khadija, the wife of the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when she said, "Kalla wallahi la yukhzika Allahu abada." Nay, nay, no, nothing wrong will happen to you. Allah will never leave you alone. Allah will be always beside you. And then she started, imagine this is like kind of wife who really will react in a good way with her husband who's coming very scared and very cold. So I want you to just like think about your wife if you are coming home and you left somebody like scared you outside, or you Allah saved you from an accident that would happen to you, and you're coming very scared and like, or very cold, in that severe cold, like living in such cold area. And when you come like this and you find your wife like finding you like this, or what, like think about what will happen with you. Your wife might tell you just get into your room and relax, you will be okay, and she will leave you alone. But look at Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when she saw her husband, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, coming and seeing them, miluni, cover me, put me under the cover, and she said to him, Allah will never leave you alone because you are such a great person. And look what she said about him. Look what she told us about this great man, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's a witness, shahada, from a testimony from his wife Khadija radiallahu anha. And that's before she knows that he's a prophet, before anything else. She lived with him all that time, like 15 years before the revelation come to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She said, إِنَّكَ لَتَصِلُ الرَّحِمُ وَتَحْمِلُ الْكَلُّ وَتُكْسِبُ الْمَعْدُومُ وَتُقْرِ الضَّيْفُ وَتُعِينُ عَلَى نَوَائِبِ الْحَقِّ. She said, you are such person who relate his family, such person who has a good relationship to his family, and you are such person who help those who are in need, those who are weak. You help them, you carry with them, you give hand to those who are in need to your hand. So she said that to the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, and she said, and you give from your wills that Allah give to you, you help those people who are in need, those who are less fortunate than you, you help them, and you are very generous to your guest. You are so generous to your guest, and you are always on the side of haqq. You are always on the side of the truth. You don't cheat, you don't lie, you don't do things which is negative and bad. And that is before he, Isa, before she knows that he is a prophet, before she knows what happens, she said to him all these characters that are exist in this great man, in our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that is something that really we need to know, we need to reflect, we need to understand that in order for you to be a good person, in order that Allah will save and protect you, to be a person who have a good relationship with his parents, have a great and good behavior with his relatives, he always relate them, he doesn't ignore them, he doesn't talk to them only in Eid times or in Ramadan times. No, he always in a good relation and a good contact with his brothers and his sisters. That's why Allah will help you. And our Prophet Muhammad ﷺ said something great regard this one, مَنْ سَرَّهُ أَنْ يُبْسَطْ لَهُ فِي رِزْقِهِ أَوْ يُنْسَأْ لَهُ فِي أَسَرِهِ فَلْيَصَلْ رَحِمَهُ. He said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, whomsoever wants that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open for him the ways of rizq, or he wants that Allah will make his life longer, let him relate his kinship. Let him relate his family members. That will make you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That will make you always in a good position, bi-iznillahi ta'ala. So this is exactly what happens with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From the good characters as well, that you help the people who are in need for your help. Somebody is weak, somebody is stuck on the snow, somebody is stuck on the traffic. You help him to come out of this problem. Somebody asked you a question, you help him to relieve him, to make him in a better position. So that's important for us, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Always remember this. And always remember what happens with Rasulullah. We will continue, inshallah ta'ala. After the break, please don't go away. I will be with you shortly. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
To a new edition of your program, Gardens of the Pious. In the series of explaining the marvelous collection of Riyad al-Salihin by Imam al-Nawawi, may Allah have mercy on him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the reward for the salah which is offered by a person in jama'ah, in congregation, is more than 20 times greater than of the same salah performed in one's house. I bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship.
There is no God worthy of worship.
But Allah alone.
But Allah alone.
And I bear witness.
And I bear witness.
That Muhammad, peace be upon him.
That Muhammad, peace be upon him.
Was his last messenger.
Is his last messenger.
And nights, may Allah make every moment that we live in this life a happy moment for his sake and worship.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Back again after the break. I would love to say to you that everyone who is watching this episode to say sallallahu alaihi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because we are talking about the most beloved one to our hearts, our Prophet Muhammad. May peace and blessings be upon him. In this situation that happens between him sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his wife Khadija radiallahu anha, a great situation. We will continue exactly what she said to him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that's what we need to know, what we need to apply in our life, because this is part of our life. Don't forget that. Don't ignore that. Always think about being a good person, so that when you are in difficulty, Allah will help you. And this is exactly, that was exactly what she said, what Khadija radiallahu anha said to our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She said to him, "Innaka la tasilu rahim." وتكسب المعدوم وتحمل الكل وتعين على نوائب الحق وتقر الضيف. As she said to him, so we continue. When you help somebody in need, Allah will help you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be beside you when you are in need. And the Prophet Muhammad himself, he taught us this in some ahadith, alayhi salatu wasalam. وتكسب المعدوم. You also give a hand to somebody who is in need of your hand. When Allah blessed you with so much, Allah has given you a lot of wealth or business, you can help somebody to work, you can help somebody to give sadaqah to someone who's in need, to help somebody to pay back his debts, and all stuff like that. That will help a person when he or she is in need, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be beside them. So as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, for example, in one hadith, تعرف على الله في الرخاء يعرفك في الشدة. If you know Allah in the easiness, Allah will help you when you are in difficulty, or as he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Also, being generous to somebody who's visiting you, that's very important. You know, when somebody like very famous, when somebody is visiting a family or somebody, so they start instead of giving him food and he's hungry, so they give him something that's just to make him full, like lots of water, lots of juice, so that when the food comes, he doesn't eat that much. No, actually, being generous to your guest is part of faith. And you know, Khadija radiallahu anha, she said that to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in that situation when he came back from the cave of Hira, very scared and very, very cold, and saying, "Cover me." She said to him that, she said, "Because you are good to your guests. You are a person who takes care of his guest and he does lots of good things to him." That's very important as well. When you do that with your guest, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you. You know, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said something great. "Man kana yu'minu billahi wal yawm al-akhir falyukrim dayfahu." Whomsoever is believing in Allah and believing in the last day, let him be generous to his guest. So that's a good character that we need to know, and we need to see in ourselves, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be beside us when we are in a problem or difficulty. So look at that. That happens with Rasulullah sallam. His wife said to him, "Watuqri al-dayf." You take care of your guest. You are generous with your guest, which is a good quality that is needed for everybody. "Tu'inu ala nawa'ib al-haq." you are very good person, a good man who help people who are in need. So we ask Allah that we are the same and do as much as we can from the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. That's very important and very well needed from us as believers who are the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So, my dear brothers, when that happens with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, what Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha did, she did not leave the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam sleeping at home, and she didn't ask what happens for him. No, no. She, when he told her about what happened in this situation in Ghar, in the cave of Hira, she took him, she said, I will go to her cousin Waraqa ibn Nawfal. Who was Waraqa ibn Nawfal? His name is Waraqa ibn Nawfal ibn Asad ibn Abd al-Uzza, and he was the cousin of Khadija, the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was a man who converted Christianity before Islam. Before he knows about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he converted to Christianity. And he used to write and read in Hebrew, and he used to learn the Gospel, the Injil, in the Hebrew language. This person, Waraqa ibn Nawfal, he's so smart and he knows about the prophets and the religions. So when Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha brought the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and came with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to her cousin, he asked him what happens. So that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started to talk to him about what happens to him. He said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him exactly all the situation that happens in the cave of Hira. So Waraqa ibn Nawfal right away said, that is a namus that was revealed to Prophet Musa and the Prophet Isa. So it means Jibreel alayhi salam. He said that was Jibreel, the angel who came to Prophet Musa alayhi salam. And he said something really needs our attention. Imagine this old man, Waraqa ibn Nawfal, the cousin of Khadija radiallahu anha, he said to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam few words after he knew that was a revelation from Allah to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said to him, يَا لَيْتَنِي فِيهَا جَزَعًا شَابًا قَوِيًّا لَيْتَنِي أَكُونُ حَيًّا إِذْ يُخْرِجُكَ قَوْمُكَ. He said, O Muhammad, I wish I am a young man, a strong person who would defend you and protect you from your family, who would kick you out of your city. He said, so the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ was shocked and amazed from the answer of Waraqa ibn Nawfal. How come you said that they will kick me out of my home, they will let me go away, and they will force me to leave my city? So Waraqa said, yes, there was no prophet except his people forced him to go away. There is no prophet, there was no prophet before you, Ya Muhammad, except his people forced him to leave his city. This is what Waraqa said to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he said to him, وَإِنْ يُدْرِكْنِي يَوْمُكَ أَنْصُرُكَ نَصْرًا مُؤَذَّرًا. So he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and if I will live until that day, yani when they start to kick you or to force you to leave your city, I will defend you until the last drop of my blood. This is what Waraqa ibn Nawfal said to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imagine this man. So this man, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in some narrations, he said that I saw him, I dreamed that he is in Jannah, pulling behind him his clothes. That was Waraqa ibn Nawfal, the cousin of Khadija, the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who has explained to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that was happened to him is the same what was happened to the prophets before you, and that was Jibreel who came to Prophet Musa alayhi salam before you. But this man didn't live that long, and he passed away after the situation, and didn't take him too long to witness the message of Islam, to witness the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam calling people to Islam. he passed away right after that, Waraqa ibn Nawfal. Then Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came back to his home, and there is no any more revelation came to him for a period of time, until he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was shocked and was like scared for something, for some reasons. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started to think, what is going to happen after this situation? And his wife Khadija radiallahu anha, once she heard the story and once she heard the explanation from her cousin Waraqa ibn Nawfal, she was the first woman to accept Islam and to be beside the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to help him and to defend him alayhi salatu wasalam, until the message of Islam became clear and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam started to give the da'wah to the people around him alayhi salatu wasalam. So what happens after that? Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, as we said, now she is the only person who is Muslim with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She is the only one who believes him. She is the only one that believes that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a prophet of Allah. The only woman who knows that what came to the Prophet is a revelation and it is from Allah, the Creator. She believes him and she trusts him, and she accepted the message of Islam with him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Right after here, after Khadija, the wife of Rasulullah, accepted Islam, who was next was his cousin Ali ibn Abi Talib, who was young boy at the time, only 10 years of age. 10 years old boy accepted Islam, accepted the message of Islam with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In these days, with all these sufferings, with all this tough life that they see in their time, accepted Islam, Ali ibn Abi Talib. Then who accepted Islam else was the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? His servant, Zayd ibn Harisa radiallahu anhu. Who was that servant? Zayd ibn Harisa, the person that his name is mentioned in the Holy Quran, the only companion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. His name is mentioned in the Quran is Zayd ibn Harisa, as Allah said in the Quran in Surah Al-Ahzab, فَلَمَّا قَضَى زَيْدٌ مِّنْهَا وَطَرًا زَوَجْنَاكَهَا. That was Zayd ibn Harisa, the servant of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They called him مَوْلَى رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. Zayd ibn Harisa, and then from the men, from the adults, from the men, was Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an. And who was Abu Bakr al-Siddiq? The famous man with his, he was so humble man, from Mecca, and the first man to accept with Rasulullah ﷺ after those two, Sayyidina Ali and Sayyidina Zayd ibn Harisa radiallahu anhum. Those ones who accepted the message of Islam was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed them to be the first ones who accept Khadija radiallahu anha, then Ali ibn Abi Talib, the young boy, 10 years old, and then the servant, Zayd ibn Harisa, also young man, and then Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa arda, the first man who accepted Islam, and then it came after lots of companions like Sayyidina Bilal ibn Rabah, radiallahu anhu al-Habashi. See, look at this beautiful, beautiful days. This is the day. These are the days that Islam is going to start. These are the days that the light is coming up slowly, slowly. Imagine ourselves, people live everywhere now. People live from the far east to the far west. People live in Canada, in America. People live in Latin America. People live in Europe. And us here, we live in Arabia, and other people live in North Africa. Other people live in Pakistan, India, Bangladesh, China, Indonesia, and all the Muslim world, all the world together, world that has majority Muslims and world that has minority Muslims, we are all believing Allah and follow Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam because of that man and because of those followers who accepted Islam with him, those companions, those friends who accepted and delivered the message of Islam to the people with love and mercy. May Allah gather us with them in paradise. We will continue talking about these beautiful days of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in our way to Medina, talking about the road to Medina, hijrah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah gather us with him in Jannah. Ameen. Until I see you in the next episode, I will leave you in the care of Allah. Astawdi'ukum Allah. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
He stepped inside his home. He was overwhelmed with fear. An angel came with words from God. Things were still unclear, saying, read, read, but he could not read. Amazing words that he heard. A trembling deep inside his heart, confused by what had occurred. There was only one who could comfort him, to help him see the light, to ease his fears, to reassure. Was Khadija his wife? He said, Zammiluni, Zammiluni, Dathiruni, Dathiruni.